Welcome back, guys. In the last lesson, we did camera tracking and created these track points. Now to export them to Max, we will use a script called AE3D Export. It's a free script. I'll provide the download link in the description. Open the link and we'll find the script over here. Just save link. Now back to After Effects. To run the script, go to File, Scripts, Run Script. Here you will get three options: Maya, Max and Lightwave. I will pick Max. Then go to Options and set the world scale to 1. If you don't do this, your exported scene will be too small. Okay, close. This browse button is not working. Usually it does, but if yours is not working too, then your file will be saved either on the desktop or in the same location as the script. Before exporting, select the layers which you want. Then hit export. Okay, it's done. Let's check. There it is. Okay. Don't include video layers while exporting. It will give error in Max. It's because Max doesn't support video formats. So we need to render this video into an image sequence. Okay, so first solo this layer and check composition settings. Our frame rate is 25. Make sure they keep same frame rate in Max as well. And set the start time code to 0. Okay, so again to composition and pre-render. Here you have output module. In this you can select which format you want to render in. I'll select JPEG sequence. Leave everything as it is. Okay. Now select the output path. I'm gonna create another folder for this, since there will be a lot of images. Okay, now hit render. It's done. Let's start Max. I'll just move this file inside. Now to import the file, simply drag and drop it in the viewport. Here we can see we got a camera and all the track points which were null objects are converted to dummies. Even the solid is converted to a dummy. And our timeline has been updated. It now has 187 frames. And if you go to time config, you can see the frame rate is now 25. The default one is 30. Okay. You don't need 4 viewports, so change the layout over here. Okay, so first one will be camera, so press C to view from camera. Then press Shift F to activate save frame. The ratio of this frame will depend on render settings. So go here and keep output size similar to the image sequence. That's because in this viewport we will be importing the image sequence as background. So if this frame ratio does not match the sequence, then the background will look squeezed or stretched and the track points won't match over it. Okay, to change the background, press Alt plus B. Then select Use Files. Check on Animate Background. Then select File. Select one image, then check Sequence over here. Then open. Include image path. Okay. The dummies are too big, we are not able to see properly. So select the dummies. Press R to activate scale and select local over here so that they get scaled down in the same position. Okay, this is enough. Now let's see. Oh, they got keyframed. Even when auto key is off, it still got keyframed. It happens because of the script we used. So just delete those keys. Okay. Now we can actually call them track points. And we even have an idea of where everything is in 3D space. The last frame is missing. Let me take care of it. Change this to 186. Okay. As you can see, the camera is facing downwards. So let's fix that. Go here to the helper panel on this one and create a point dummy. Right click here to place it in the center. Now select everything except the point dummy and parent link everything to it. Let me explain what parent link is, since we are going to use it a lot in the next lesson. Here we have select and link button, toggle it. Now to link something, press left click and hold it, then go on another object and release the left click. So here, this one is the child and this one is the parent. So just like any Indian family, child can't control the parent, but the parent can control the child. So now this object will control the position, rotation and scale of the child. Now if I link the parent to this object, then this guy will become your school principal. So if I rotate this, both child and parent will rotate with it. To disconnect the link, select the objects and click on this button. So here our point helper is the parent. Before rotating it, I will press A to turn on angle snap. This will make our rotation increment by 5 degrees. Now press E for rotation and rotate this to 90 degrees. I think this one was placed on the ground. Check its name. No, it's not. Yeah, this one. That's why naming is important. In perspective view, you can't tell which one is which. Did I link this one? Yeah, it's linked. So let's bring this one to the grid. So go to front view and select the point helper and pull everything up. So let's check perspective. I didn't actually hold the camera in the perfect 90 degree angle, so we might have to move this, but for now just hide it. Now we have to create a very basic model of the actor. If you guys followed this step from my previous video, then use those photos and start modeling. It will be much easier that way and your model will be a lot more precise. After completing, use these track points as a reference and place the model on top of the actor. For those who didn't follow that step, like myself, just start modeling with what you have. Let me just save the file first. And we don't need After Effects for now. Before doing anything, we need to lock the camera, because if by mistakenly you panned around in this view, it will actually move your camera. And if you forget to undo in time, then your tracking won't match the video and your scene will be completely messed up. So select the camera, go to Hierarchy tab, then Link Info, and lock Move and Rotate. Now we can't pan around here, but the camera animation works perfectly fine. Alright, now start modeling. As I said before, I won't include 3D modeling in this series. Just make a very basic model, no detailing needed, and its topology can be messy. Just make it smooth. We will use this model for three things: to place Ironman parts on, to capture contact shadows, and to hide models which go behind the actor. So lesson 2 is complete. In lesson 3, we will set up a custom controller which will open and close the helmet by just rotating. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next video.